Choices are defeating. Purpose always fleeting.
Hey there everyone, Hitesh here, back again with another video. And in this video, we are talking about payments and how the payment works in the online world. Now, as a developer, most of the time you interact with a payment system just to integrate it in an e-commerce website or your client's website, and that's pretty much it. You don't really know what happens after that. You have given the entire product, you have shipped it, but as a consumer, there's a lot that happens in between. There's a lot of problems that you face, and especially the problem when from your account, the money was deducted, but you never got the product instantaneously. There is sometimes a delay, you get into the mess, and a whole bunch of things. So I'll divide this video into variety of scenarios or variety of cases, like what kind of things happen when you make a payment online. Now, in the past also, I have created a video which has a lot of technical jargons in it, like how these tokens are being made and how these tokens reach to each other and a whole bunch of other things. In this video, I'll keep it absolutely at a ground level so that everybody who is making a purchase online can understand what goes wrong and what goes right, when you need to hit that panic button, and how the things will process or reverse back, and how things will get sorted out. So let's get started and talk about the online payment systems at a very ground level. Before I talk about this online payment systems, let me inform you that I do have my fair share of experience in working with variety of payment gateways. I've integrated with them, I've studied a lot about their APIs and variety of projects, including Braintree, PayPal, Stripe, Razorpay, InstaMojo, PayYouMoney, Paytm, and a whole bunch of others as well. But this is not regarding that. This is regarding about general purchasing, just like I purchase on websites like Flipkart or Swiggy or Amazon or any other as well. So let's start with the cases or scenarios that happens when you make an online purchase. Case numero uno, case number one. This is the most easiest one, and all the merchant and all the clients and everybody just loves it. In the one of the previous video, I also mentioned that when you purchase from any website, you don't make payment to the direct owner of that website. For example, when you make a payment from Amazon or any food websites like Swiggy, you are not making payment directly to the owner of that website. You are making a payment through a payment gateway, and these payment gateways, based on the deals that we have cracked with them, sometimes charges 3% to 0.5% based on variety of scenarios and amount of transactions that are being made on a website. You're making a payment to those payment gateways, and those payment gateways just don't send us the direct money. They send us a token, and that token and information is there, whether the payment was successful, was it authorized, was it canceled, what happened with that. So we just work on these websites through that payment gateway. So let me clear this up. You make a payment onto a website, the website opens up the payment gateway, you make a payment on the payment gateway, and payment gateway passes us the information onto the website. That's clear up. Now also during that, there are a variety of compliances that we have to follow. Like there is one PCI compliance, which is payment card industry data security compliance. I know it's a big word and big jargon, but these payment gateway actually helps us to follow all these compliances and all these rules and regulation. Now moving back onto the part where I was talking about how these payment gateway works. So scenario number one. In the scenario number one, I would love to keep two things, which are absolutely simple. Case number one, you made a payment, it got authorized, it got a success successfully, it was processed on the website successfully, you got your course, you got your food delivery or whatever you were asking of, everything goes nicely, everybody loves it. And in the sub part of this, like part two, in that case, you have entered the card information probably wrong, probably the name on the card was entered wrong, or the PIN was wrong, or maybe there was insufficient balance. In that case, you got a decline or the failure, and that's also fine. These all things are actually being loved by merchant because there is a total transparency. Either it got it or we don't got it. So this is something which every merchant loves. The things get tricky in the case number two. The case number two is actually tricky, in which you make a payment, the payment was deducted from your account, but on the website it says payment was not made or transaction failed or you didn't got the product. So what is happening in that case? Now, before I go further, it's totally okay to hit that panic button during this mode because you made a payment, you were expecting that the things will get into my account or the order will be successful, and it didn't got. And your amount was also deducted. Now, this is something that usually happens with the network traffic. Now, because on these payment gateways, sometimes the traffic is too high to make all these payments. Now, this is a very rare case scenario. Probably in thousands of, you'll get be the one person, or probably sometimes in 10,000, you'll be the one person. But they do occur. They do happen a lot. So in that case, you made a payment. Your payment was deducted, but your payment was in the queue of the bank to successfully allow it to be deducted. But since you got the message of deduction, but the process or the payment was still in the queue. Now, these websites which we design, probably LearnCode Online or Swiggy, they are designed that we wait for the token to come from the payment gateway for a limited amount of time. We cannot keep our payment gateway open like forever. We have to shut it down and we have to wait for that token. So if that token comes after when the gateway was closed from our website, your payment now is in the air. It got deducted from your account, but it never reached to our account. So in that case, the transaction actually comes into the different stage, which is known as authorized state. In that case, your payment was deducted. It's there, marked as authorized, that you can deduct it, but it never reached to the payment website. So in that case, what the merchant does, it goes manually and capture that payment. So we have to process such things manually. So sometimes these cases are resolved when you write a mail to the organization, or sometimes they keep on checking these things every 12 to 14 hours. Like in our case, we check such things like every 14 hours or 15 hours, and we manually check whether there was some authorized payment or not. It happens. It happens a lot when you have huge number of transactions going on in every single day. So these things are pretty common to happen. So in that case, whom to blame? I would say the network congestion should be blamed. It's not the merchant who is doing anything wrong. It's not that you are doing anything wrong. It's just the traffic that sometimes keep things in the middle and things get messy there. The scenario number three is actually the worst case scenario for the merchant side as well as for the customer side. These are very rare scenario, but trust me, they also happen. These are very rare, like in 5,000 or 10,000 to 1. The ratio is pretty high, but they do occur. I have seen a lot of them. So how this scenario works? You make a payment on the website. The payment was deducted from your end, but somehow the bank processed the wrong signal to the payment gateway, and it processed the wrong signal as failed to the payment gateway. Payment gateway will further send the information to the website that this transaction was failed. But now, since you have got the payment deducted from your account, but the payment gateway and the website got the signal of a failed transaction, things get messy. Payment was deducted from your side. Merchant says, we got your transaction as failed. What to do? Now, in that case, the bank is actually responsible for that. But banks are very tricky. You cannot blame the banks directly. They are pretty cautious about it. So what they do, after a few hours, probably 3 to 4 hours is the window that I have personally seen, in the 3 to 4 hours, they send another signal to the same payment that was processed, and they mark this payment as authorized. So what will happen after 3 to 4 hours? They change their signal from failed to authorized, and these are late marked as authorized. In that case, merchant has a couple of options. Either he can refund that payment or can capture that payment and process the order or whatever he likes to do. But this is a pretty panicky situation. You are saying that my payment got deducted. Merchant is saying, I don't know where your payment is. It says it is marked as failed. And after 3 hours, the payment was processed. So you blame the merchant that, hey, you said it was failed, then how come you were able to process it later on? Now, in that case, obviously the bank is somebody who is to be blamed, but they don't accept their fault right away. They just mark it later on. So again, this is a situation where I would recommend just wait for a few moments, probably 3 to 4 hours, and things will get sorted out, hopefully. But the good thing is, since all of these websites and payment gateways follow the PCI compliance, there is never going to be a scenario where your payment was deducted and you didn't got the product. All these payment gateways are made or designed in such a way that they are on the auto refund policy. If some some of the purchase that you have made is marked as authorized and the merchant is not able to capture that, eventually after 2 to 3 days, they will be automatically refunded back into your account. So it's not like your payment is going to be stuck somewhere where nobody is looking. It will either get processed in the merchant side, or if merchant is not manually capturing it, it will 100% be processed back in your account. Whew. Too much of the information in just one video, but there is one thing more, which is how these refund actually works and why does this refund actually take so much of the time. So when you make a payment on the online website and you expect that payment will go through there, it's not like that the payment gateway sends the token and just after a few minutes of the token, it transfers the payment. It rarely happens that. And your refund is highly dependent on the payment cycle of that payment gateway and the website. So let's just say you buy a product and you didn't like that product or you want a refund for that product. So in that case, your refund will be marked to be refunded, but your refund will be processed on the day when that transaction will be processed on the merchant account. It's a little bit confusing thing, but these payments are being held by the payment gateway for X number of days, sometimes 3 days, sometimes 1 day, sometimes 4 days, depends what kind of deal you were able to crack. So up till and then, that payment is just there. It is marked sometime as refund, sometimes marked as to be processed to merchant. Whatever will happen after 2 days or 3 days. So if the payment was marked as refund, after 3 days, your payment will start processing. And since there are two banks involved here, the bank of the payment gateway and your bank, they also have to synchronize. So in that process, sometimes it takes 2 more days, and that's why your refund takes 4 to 5 days and sometimes more than a week to process your payment back. So yeah, it's a complicated world in the systems. And when you work on a startup or anything, these are the information that are very crucial to you and you should know them. Now, surely I would accept that these kinds of information is not usually accessible to the developer because we never actually do so much of the work in the payment gateway. And in the recent few years only, I got involved so much in the payment gateways and I got this much of the information. So I thought I'd just share it with you as well. Now, in case you would like me to more explain about these payment gateways and probably design something more or a comparison video on different kind of payment gateways, do let me know in the comment section. I have plenty of experience with variety of payment gateways and I can surely make a video on that. So that's it for this video and let's catch up in the next one. You're gonna come. Truth is too revealing. Life is easier concealing. All emotions to the star on your heart going numb. I shouldn't be in drive more. I just want to feel alive more. I feel hurt all the time, boy, I can't see straight. I've been running on the freeway till I get blinded by the headlights. They go past me, I see the last me, I ever will be. That got me asking.